On the last class, we started to see the presente do indicativo, verbos regulares, in are, er, and ir. We saw that all of them, they have specific terminations, which are regular. Some of them are the same, like er and ir, they are almost the same, with the difference of nós. But they are also very similar to are. We saw the difference between presente do indicativo, that in Turkish is geniş zaman or simple present in English, and estar a mais infinitivo, which in Turkish is şimdiki zaman, okay? The present continuous. We saw the difference and we saw for which cases we use presente do indicativo, verbos regulares. We did some exercises as well. And I have asked you, if I'm not mistaken, if I am, please let me know. I mean, I have many different classes and sometimes I confuse which exercises we did here and not. I believe we did this one together and then the others I left for you to do. Also, I asked you to check the unidade 5, unidade 6 e unidade 8 from the Gramática Ativa book and try to do the exercises. So, the first thing I want to start this class before we move to the other part of the class we will start today. I want to ask you. If you have any questions, any doubts, any difficulties, any comments, anything, okay? So let's start talking about your study of verbos regulares and problems or questions, problemas ou questões que vocês tiveram, that you may have. Who wants to start?
Bir senanın buyurun. Açtım mikrofonunuzu.
Olá, professor, bom dia.
Olá, Cristina, bom dia.
I have a question regarding exercise book 6.3. See the unit 6, 6.3. Şimdi, until 1 to 10, I understood that everything with the first person, no, answers correct. And then the second one with Wolsey. No? This is like common unos bolinhos. The answer is comemos. No, it can be, but can it be? Happen with if they are, and the answers it could be common solo.
Yes, you're right. So comem,
oh, comem.
Sorry, it's the form we use for vocês or eles, elas. So for cis, the plural cis in Turkish, or onlar. Okay.
Oh, okay. So it was optional. Option,
yes, right? Yeah, you can answer like we eat. So someone is asking, Yani, do you eat, like plural you, plural sis? And you can say, yes, we eat. So comemos. Claro. Or you can say, onlar e olar. They eat. Okay. So yes, you're correct. This can be comemos, or the answer can also be comem.
Muito obrigada.
Just one thing, there is for the for all of you for the verbs in are and ir, there are some graphical changes in some of them. In the book of exercises, they are mentioned in unidade 6, but also unidade 8. I did not mention this last class, but I will mention this today. Okay, some verbs change in the first person of the singular. We will see this today. But before coming to there, any other questions? any other doubts regarding these exercises, either from the main book, Português Já, ou o livro de exercícios, Gramática Ativa. Questões? Questions?
Ekinan'ın buyurun.
Hola, professor.
Olá, bom dia.
In our last classes, we were talking about, since we don't have answers for these books, could you give us the answers?
We have.
We have?
Yes, on the first class, I didn't want to tell you because we were at the beginning.
But okay, okay.
But mm-hmm. At the end of the book, at the end of the book, you have the answers to that.
Okay, it is a bit weird because I never checked. Anyway, thank you, professor.
If you go to the end of the book, for example, here, you see that you have all the answers.
Okay.
But but try
because
to...
we were talking about there was no answer key, so I didn't see any reason to check. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I didn't want to say it at the beginning, but...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah, but you can get it from there.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Mais questões, mais perguntas sobre os exercícios, about the exercises. Any questions? Just trying to get my charger. Guys, do you have any questions? First, did you do the exercises? Did you practice at home? I guess your silence means either yes or no. So let's do together this last three that we did not do in class. So I would ask you, any of you, I need three volunteers, so no, to complete the B, C, and D. Three people, três pessoas, para fazer o B, o C e o D. Who wants to start? Anyone?
Actually, with Birsen Hanım, it's three. Okay, Başak Hanım also joined.
Okay. You can decide the order, Meryem, please. It doesn't matter.
Okay. Ekin Hanım, buyurun.
Okay, I will start with B.
Mm-hmm.
Eu e Rui moramos num quatro em Gaia e trabalhamos no Porto. Sorry, it is a bit hard for me to write my handwriting.
Okay. Just one thing that you said that reminded me of something.
Okay.
There are some words in Portuguese that they are written in a very similar way, but they have different meanings. For example, this word, quarto, means room, okay? Oda.
Okay.
But quatro, as you said, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
Quatro means four, okay? Mm-hmm. Third, it's the number. So just be careful with this. It's mm-hmm. quarto, not quatro.
Okay.
So muito bem, it's correct. Next one, próximo.
Eylem Hanım, buyurun.
Bom dia.
Bom dia.
Eu sou alemão e vivo quarto alugado.
E vivo num... so, I think, yes, this one is quarto or... apartamento.
Quarto,
yes,
apartamento or quarto?
Yeah, this one, according to what we did before.
Yes, apartamento.
This, the one that Akin did, it should be
apartamento.
Apartamento. And this one is quarto alugado.
Quarto alugado.
Em Lisboa, sim. Alugado means rented, ok? Rented. Em Lisboa. You can say, you can use alemão or alemã, ok? Because we have nothing from here that tells us it's a woman or a man. If it's a man, alemão. If it's a woman, alemã. Última, last one. Who would like to do?
Başakanım, buyurun. Mikrofonunuz kapalı, Başakanım. Hala kapalı. Şu an aç.
Açıldı mı? Hola.
Va, bom dia.
Tu apanhas o autocarro às seis e chegas a casa. I can't read.
Às seis e cinquenta. I will. We will start. We will start next class. I will make at the beginning. I will make a short time, 10-15 minutes, to tell you the numbers. Okay. And also, I'm not sure if it's next one or one after. We will start. I think next one. We will start checking these prepositions. Okay. All of these things are prepositions. They are connectors. They connect the elements of the sentences. Sometimes they connect our sentences with places, like this one, à escola, or no Porto, or em Gaia. They are place prepositions. Sometimes they tell us the time, and these are time prepositions. Okay, they are all the same. But we use it for different contexts, and we will start, I think, I don't have the program here, but I think next class we will start seeing these connectors, okay, which are very important to bring the different parts of the sentences together. Muito bem. Tu apanhas o autocarro às seis, okay, I wrote it here, not in the extensive form. Seis. You can say 18, which is 11, or you can say seis. But if you use seis, alte, then you have to say if it's morning or afternoon. In this case, it's afternoon, so seis da tarde, okay? Seis e cinquenta da tarde, because it's afternoon, okay? But of course, if you say 18 horas, okay, 11, then it's obvious that it's afternoon. But if you prefer to use this time, this seis, okay, alte, you have to say seis da tarde. Muito bem. Before we pass to this different, to this graphical changes on the first person of the singular in the verbs er, ir, before we go there, I want to do a listening exercise with you, okay? What we will hear is a very short vocabulary, very basic vocabulary, in which there will be some verbs, some elements that we did not learn yet. Okay, for example, this verb vi, it's past tense. So we didn't learn it yet, but don't focus on those, focus on the verbs that we have to complete here. And the verbs we have to complete here are ser, estar, and present, simple present, okay? Presente do indicativo, verbos regulares. So the verbs that we learned so far. So let's listen to this vocabulary 1, 2, 3 times, whatever, and then let's complete the blank spaces together. Just let me know, I will play it. Let me know if you can hear it well.
Página 14, Português em Ação.
Can you hear it well?
Yes.
Okay. So let's start from the beginning.
Página 14, Português em Ação.
Olá, sou o João. Como estás?
Olá, João. Muito prazer. Sou a Camila.
Apanhas este autocarro todos os dias?
Sim, moro em Cascais, mas estudo em Lisboa, na escola secundária de Camões.
Curioso. Eu também.
Bem, chegamos. Tenho de me apressar. As minhas aulas começam às 8h30.
Ótimo. As minhas também. Eu acompanho-te.
Página 14.
Once again.
Português em ação.
Olá, sou o João. Como estás?
Olá, João. Sou a Mila.
Nunca te vi por aqui. Apanhas este autocarro todos os dias?
Sim, moro em Cascais, mas estudo em Lisboa, na escola secundária de Camões.
Curioso, eu também.
Bem, chegamos. Tenho de me apressar. As minhas aulas começam às 8h30.
Ótimo, as minhas também. Eu acompanho-te.
Página.
One more, or it's okay for you?
One more, please.
Okay, one more.
14. Português em ação.
Olá, sou o João. Como estás?
Olá, João. Muito prazer. Sou a Camila.
Nunca te vi por aqui. Apanhas este autocarro todos os dias?
Sim. Moro em Cascais, mas estudo em Lisboa, na escola secundária de Camões.
Curioso. Eu também.
Bem, chegamos. Tenho de me apressar. As minhas aulas começam às 8h30.
Ótimo. As minhas também. Eu acompanho-te.
Não. Either you could do it or not, it's not a problem. I will help. What I need, let's try two or three times with some of you to read this dialogue. Okay, so I need to, let's do something like this. Let's do two people for the first part and then two people for the second part. Okay, so this is the first part until here, until Camões. And then the second part until accompanied. So for the first attempt, I need four people. Who wants to start? Don't worry about the pronunciation, if you could do or not. The important thing is you try, you start reading in Portuguese, okay? So then I know what are your difficulties.
So there is Mustafa Bey and Birsan Hanım also raising hands.
Okay, so we have Mustafa, Birsan, Adam. Someone else? We need one more for the first trial. One more person.
Dilek Hanım from chat said she can also do it. So there's
okay, both. So let's decide who starts. Maybe Dilek and Birsen, and then we have Mustafa and Eylem. Okay, so Birsen and Dilek, please, until Camões. Maybe Birsen can be A and Dilek can be B.
Dilek Hanım, açtı mikrofonunuzu.
Olá.
Olá.
Olá. Eylem Hanım, sizin de açtım.
So,
Birsen Hanım, pardon. Birsen Hanım, sizin de açtım.
Olá, sou o João. Como estás?
Olá, João. Muito prazer. Sou a Camila.
Nunca te vi por aqui. I don't know this part.
Actually.
Just read what there is written. Then we can complete later.
Este. Eu quero So this L or.
No. Just read from here until here. Este autocarro todos os dias.
Este autocarro todos os dias.
Muito bem. Bissan.
Sim, moro em Cascais, mas estudo em Lisboa, na escola secundária de Camões.
Muito bem, muito obrigado. Agora, A and Eilem B.
Eylem Hanım, mikrofonunuz açık. Mustafa Bey, sizin de açtın mikrofonunuzu.
Açık değil mi? Şu anda duyuyorsunuz.
Duyuyoruz.
Duyuyorum.
Yes. Duyuyorsa evo tamben.
Bey, chegamos, tenho de me apressar, minhas aulas começam às 8:30.
Continuo as minhas também, eu acompanho-te.
Muito bem, muito obrigado, Cristiane, Dilek, Mustafa e Eilem. Now, four more people. Let's do it one more time. Don't worry if you could do the exercise or not. I just want you to read. So, do we have volunteers? Okay, one, two, three. No. Set up the mat. We need two more, no? Come on, just don't be shy. Just try. That's the point of being here.
We have four.
Okay, muito bem. So who are the four? Serap, Demet, Meral, and Başak. Okay, let's start with Serap and Demet. Serap can be A, Demet can be B, and then Meral and Başak. For the second part.
Serap Hanım, Demet Hanım, açtım mikrofonlarınızı.
Ben mi başlıyordum? Am I starting?
Sim, pode começar.
Okay. Olá, sou a João. Como está?
Serap Hanım, açtım mikrofonunuzu.
Ok. Olá, professor.
Olá.
Olá, João. Muito prazer. Sou a Camila.
Nunca te vi por aqui. Prende este autocarro todos os dias?
Sim. Vivo em Cascais, mas estudo em Lisboa na escola secundária de Camões.
Camões. Obrigado.
Mas...
Başak e Meral, não?
Başak Hanım, açtım mikrofonunuzu. Meral Hanım, sizin de açtım.
Okay. Curiosa em tembem. Bem, chegar tenho de me apressar às minhas aulas.
Às 8:30.
Oitimo, as minhas também, eu acompanho-te.
Muito obrigado a todos. Now, let's hear one more time and then I will complete and I will tell you some of the problems with some of the words you had difficulties pronouncing. Let's hear it once more.
Página 14, Português em Ação.
Olá, sou o João. Como estás?
Olá, João. Muito prazer. Sou a Camila.
Nunca te vi por aqui. Apanhas este autocarro todos os dias?
Sim, moro em Cascais, mas estudo em Lisboa, na escola secundária de Camões.
Curioso. Eu também.
Bem, chegamos. Tenho de me apressar. As minhas aulas começam às 8:30.
Ótimo. As minhas também. Eu acompanho-te.
Olá, sou o João. Como estás? Of course, it could be as well, como está, the formal way. But they are two students, you know, they start with an informal way. So, João asks, como estás? Ok, Nasselsen. Olá, João. Muito prazer. Mesmo no último, ok? Muito prazer. You remember this. Sou a Camila. Then João says, nunca te vi por aqui. I never saw you around here. Around, okay? Nunca means ichbizaman, never. Apanhas este autocarro todos os dias? Do you get? Okay, we saw this last class. Apanhar, we use it for catching a transportation. Apanhas este autocarro todos os dias? Do you get this bus every day? Sim. Camila says, sim. Moro, ou vivo, some of you said vivo, vivo is also possible. Moro em Cascais. Cascais, it's near Lisbon, on the coastline. Mas estudo em Lisboa. But I study in Lisbon. Na escola secundária de Camões. On the secondary school of Camões. Curioso, curious, irguinte. Eu também. Também is, eu também means bende, me too. Okay? Também in English is too. And we read it like também, também. Bem, well, chegamos, we arrive. Okay? We arrive. Chegamos. Tenho de me apressar. Apressar means to hurry up. I have to hurry up. As minhas aulas, benim derslerim, ok? My classes começam, başlıyor, começam às 8:30, 8:30. Ótimo. As minhas também. Mine too. Ok? So, também. We have here também. Eu acompanho-te. I will accompany you. I will join you. I will go with you. Or I go with you. Okay. In general, you had your pronunciation was okay, no problems. There is some words that I got. For example, you still have problems with this M, okay, João, it's normal. Some of you said aqui, okay, it's not aqui. In this case, we don't read U, so aqui, okay, we read it like this, aqui. Somewhat também, you had some difficulties in também, but it's a difficult word to pronounce, okay? Também. Try to divide it in two syllables, tan and bem. One syllable, okay? Tan, one syllable, bem, two syllables. And that was it, okay? In general, it was quite good. So, muito obrigado pela vossa participação, for your participation. Any questions about this text before we move on? Alguma pergunta? Any question? No? Ok, vamos continuar. Let's continue. So, as I said, on the exercise book, you have three units dedicated for the verbos regulares. You have unidade 5 para verbos regulares em ar, okay? Here, no problem. I think you did some of the exercises or not. Just one thing, especially this exercício 5.4 é muito importante. It's very important because you have to use some adverbs, to make sentences. And these adverbs are important, especially nunca and sempre. Nunca means never, as we saw in the exercise before. Normalmente means normally or genericle. Sempre, always. And raramente, it's like nadiren, okay? Rarely. Almost never. So it's a good exercise. You can, if you didn't do it yet, please do it. And if you have any questions, you can always ask me. Can also be next class. Now let's go where I want, the thing I want to show you now. Although these are regular verbs, verbos regulares, okay? And they have always the same termination, okay? They end the same way for all the regular ones. There are some verbs that change the way we write them just for the first person of singular. What means first person of singular? Means eu. Okay? First person of singular means eu. Primeira pessoa do singular. So only for that case, it changes the way we write these verbs. So what are these verbs? Let's start with conhecer. Conhecer means to know someone, to know a place. Not know in terms of bilmek, okay? In terms of tanmak, okay? Like to know someone, to know a place, to have to a place you have been, a song you know because you have listened to, a book you know because you read that book, okay? We use conhecer for that. For example, eu conheço o João, okay? Or eu conheço este livro, I know this book. Or eu conheço esta música, I know this music, this song. We use it for that. As you see, there is a small change in how we write these verbs. Okay? We put a che, Turkish che, but in Portuguese we read it like double S. We read it like S. So, eu conheço, eu deixo, eu esqueço, eu aqueço. So, conhecer, we have seen that it means to know someone or something. Descer means inmek, okay? To go down from a place, okay? Inmek. Esquecer is to, it's unutmak, to forget. Aquecer, it's to warm something, to warm a coffee, to warm milk, to warm a place. So why does this thing, these verbs, on the first person of singular, change from a C to this che, that we read like S in Portuguese? Why does it change? The reason is the sound. So the verb, the main verb, conhecer, or descer, what is the sound? The sound is conhecer, ser. We have this S sound, or descer. If you would write it following the rule of just putting an O, we would have this, right? But C-O in Portuguese, we read it like P-O, like this. We read it like this. Conheco, desco. And we don't want this sound. We want the S sound, the original sound of the verb. Conhecer, descer. So in order to not make this, okay, we need... There is this graphical rule of changing and putting, instead of je, we put che. That, because in Portuguese, we read it like S. So that's why we read it like conheço or deixo. This is the reason why we change it for these verbs. Okay? I forgot one, which is parecer. Parecer means to look alike or benzemek. Okay, to look alike, to look like something. Also, we have the same thing for abranger, which is not an important verb. I will pass this verb. I mean, it's almost impossible that you will lose this verb. It's a very specific verb that it's in English. It means encompass. So it's not even a verb that you use that much in English. But proteger, it's an important verb. Proteger means to protect. Okay, to protect. The same thing happens. What is the sound of the main verb? Proteger. It's G sound. In Portuguese, when you have a G followed, when you have a G and after you have E, the sound is G. Okay, proteger. But If you would write like this, okay, so the main verb is proteger. If you would write like eu protejo with a G, G-O in Portuguese, we read it like go. So it would be eu protego. And we don't want this sound of G, we want the sound of G. So that's why this is wrong. And the correct version is eu protejo, okay? But only for the first person of singular. As you can see, the second, tu proteges. It follows the same rule, okay? We don't need to change anything. Just for eu, okay? Just for eu. The same thing we find in the unidade 8 for some ir verbs, okay? Some ir verbs, when we have on the first syllable e, like vestir, despir, preferir, these are the first set, and then we have another set of verbs. We have these changes. E becomes I. Only, again, only first person of singular. Okay? We have these rules. Not for the others. The others, there's no change. Eu visto. Eu dispo. Eu sinto. Eu prefiro. Eu consigo. Eu sigo. Eu corrijo. Eu dirijo. Now, I'm not going to tell you what all these verbs mean. Okay, just take it as a homework to find on the dictionary or online, whatever, the meanings of these verbs and try to make a sentence using all of them or some of them. Okay, try to look on your own to what do they mean, how can I use them? Or you can also, if you didn't do it yet, do some exercises in which some of them you see the need to use this verb. For example, here, conseguir, seguir, another one, conseguir again, seguir, despir, corrigir, vestir, okay? Preferir. You can try to do these exercises to practice these changes. Please do it if you didn't do it yet. If you do it and you have questions, I can answer them down. If you didn't do it, please try to practice this. And on the next class, we can see some of your questions. So about this, any questions right now? In case you did the exercises and you had difficulties, you have some questions. Sim or no? Yes or no?
Gülsen Hanım, buyurun.
I have a question, just addition to your notes, that right next to page 20, next to chart of vestir, despir, there is one more irregularity. Verbs finishing with usir, for the third person, change becomes on the third person, like it noted zeta only, no z. Conducir becomes ela conduz.
Yes, precisely. There's only one case, and remember now, conduzir. Conduzir means to drive, okay? For example, eu, if we, I will conjugate it, all of it here.
Oh,
it's actually an important verb.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually to drive or to conduct. You can also use eu conduzo a aula. I conduct the lecture or the class. But it's more for to drive a car. So eu conduzo o carro. Tu conduzes. So it follows the same rules, as you can see. Tu conduzes o carro, you drive the car. Now, the change is here. Ele, ela, você conduz.
Conduz, conduz.
É at the end, it ends with Z. Conduz, ok?
Obrigada.
Conduzimos. And then finally, vocês, eles, elas
conduzem.
Okay. The only difference is here normally we have E, it ends with E. Here it ends with Z. Okay, so we don't E. That's what this means. Okay.
Obrigado.
Nada. Obrigado pela pergunta. Thank you for the question. Any other questions that you would like to ask? Sim, não?
Zehra Hanım, buyurun.
Olá, professor. I want to ask, are there any more verbs like this or only the ones we have seen here with these rules?
I think, you know, as in Turkish or as any other language who has a very extensive vocabulary, I thought about this before the class and I couldn't find others that have these problems. Okay, so they were very detailed in bringing the verbs in which there are changes on this book, not in the other book. Okay, in this book they made this list. So I cannot think right now about any other verb which ends, for example, in ger, okay, this ser in Portuguese, or ger, or in the case of ir, who ends with, not ends, who has on the first syllable ve or de or se, okay, or ends or has in the last syllable this gir or gir. I think these are the only ones. Okay, it might be one or two more, but I looked, I thought about it, I couldn't find it. So I think they are quite detailed about this. Mais alguma pergunta? Não? Okay, so as you have seen in some of the exercises, some of the sentences we have used, there are important elements to express the place or to indicate objects, which are called pronomes demonstrativos, okay? To demonstrate, that's what it means, demonstrativos, okay? You can just call them demonstrativos, okay? You can use just this short name, demonstrativos, to demonstrate. You remember that we have used este and esta sometimes, or estes, for example. If we go back to the listening exercise we saw, where can we find them? Here, este autocarro. Actually, here I think we have only one. Yes, este autocarro. Let me see if we have before. If we used before any time. Ah, yes, for example, esta agência. Yes, I think that before they don't want to use so much because before we learn it, they don't want to use it so much, but believe me, we use this a lot. Okay, these demonstrativos, we use them a lot. So let's go back. For example, this short dialogue between João and Isabela. Chegamos, Isabela. Esta é a minha casa. Uau, Este apartamento é enorme. E estes, quem são? We arrived, Isabella. This is my house. Wow, this apartment is huge. Or kojaman, okay, very big. And this, who are they? So this dialogue is actually quite good because it tells you different cases we use this demonstrativos. For example, esta casa, this is my house. And so we are using to indicate, to demonstrate an object, a place. This apartment is huge, okay, or very big. And now we have a different case in which we use, again, demonstrativos. This, who are they? So now we are using demonstrativos, not for places or objects, but for people. And this, because this is the plural, okay? It has a S at the end. Who are they? Okay, quem são? Who are they? So, there are two sets of demonstrativos. In Turkish, you have three demonstrativos, actually, bu, şu, and o, or, of course, the plural, bunlar, şunlar, onlar. In Portuguese, we have, of course, also three. In English, there are only this, that. They only have two in English. They have this and that, this and those. Okay, so they have also two, and then they have singular and plural. In Turkish, you have. Let me write it so it's better if you see it, what I'm talking about. In Turkish, you have bu, şu, and o, or the plural, bunlar. If I'm making a mistake, please tell me, okay? I'm not proficient in English. So if I'm saying something wrong, please tell me. Online. Okay, so you have two sets. Singular and plural. Now, why do we use... What is the difference between using bu, şu, and o? Or bunlar, şunlar, onlar? What is the difference? This, would anyone would like to tell me? And then we compare with the Portuguese.
Ben anladım, buyurun.
We can see the page you wrote. Is the word page? We can see it.
So can you see this page only?
We can only see Portuguese ja.
So wait a second. There must be a problem because what about now? Can you see it?
Yes.
Okay. So what is the difference between these? In which cases you use bu, şu, and o? I mean, why you change? Eylem, por favor.
I think, do you want me to speak in Turkish or English?
You can say it in Turkish.
Okay, so bu, when we say bu, the object is close to us, right? Bu kitap.
Mm-hmm.
Şu, referring to something far away. Mm-hmm. Şu kitap. Mm-hmm. And o, I don't know, the difference between o kitap, o and şu, I think, synonymously used in Turkish. Şu kitap. O, şu, bu, o, synonymously used, I believe.
Okay, does anyone want to add anything to this? Go ahead. Whoever wants to talk, to say.
Bunlar, şunlar, onlar, the plural forms, of course.
Yeah, yes, of course, of course. Yeah. But what I'm asking is why, I mean, the difference. So Eylem said it's about if the object is closer or a bit far from you. Does anyone want to add on this? Anything?
Like this, that, you know, this book, that. Yes.
Anyone wants to add anything? Okay, Hisan.
When we say "oh," we don't see the object. It is far away.
Okay.
When we talk about. But when we see the "bu," when we say "bu," it's close to us. A little bit further away, we say "şu." And if we don't see it, we call it "o."
Okay. Obrigado. So in Portuguese, there's also three. And the reason why we use esse or aquele in masculino, or esta, essa, aquela, it's exactly the same reason. Exactly the same reason. It's if it's closer to you or a bit far from you. Exactly the same thing. So, but of course, in Portuguese, it becomes more complicated because we have gender. So, este, it's masculino. Or esta, feminino. Then we have esse or essa. And then we have, at last, aquele. Again, we don't read the U, aquele, aquela. Okay, so same division as bucho, o. If someone is writing on the chat, I would prefer that you speak. You can say it in Turkish. You can say it in Turkish, okay? Türkçe kullanabilirsiniz. Yani problem değil. But it's better if you speak, so because otherwise I have to open, read your comment. It's not very dynamic. So if you have something to say, raise your hand and say it anytime, no problem. So, este, esta, esse, essa, aquele, aquela. And then we have the plurals. Estes, that you just put, you add an S. Estes, ML, just a second, let me finish this and then you can say it. Estas, okay. Esses, essas. Aqueles, aquelas. Okay. The same thing, the only difference is we have S here. In Portuguese, every time a word ends with a vowel, A, E, I, O, U, if you put a S, if you add an S at the end, you have the plural. That's the rule. So the difference in, okay, before that, I think someone wanted to make a question or say something. Go ahead.
Emel Hanım, buyurun.
Merhaba.
Mikrofonunuz kapandı Emel Hanım.
So, hello.
Hello.
Hi, I had a question. In Turkish, this O, we use it also for something specific. If we say o kişi, it means this person, so we have to refer to someone, and we can just answer with o kişi. And can we say it also in Portuguese that we say aquela pessoa or aquela pessoa? Is it possible?
Yes, it's possible. Okay. We will see when we use this. It's possible for refer to objects, places, and people. Okay, so that is not a problem. We can refer to objects, places, people. What I want you to tell you is, in terms of the difference, este, esta, esse, essa, aquilo, aquela, it's the same thing as in Turkish. Okay, if the object is closer to you or farther away from you. But in what sense? It's always referring to the person that speaks. So if, just a second, let me stop sharing. Now, if I'm holding a book, I would say este livro, okay? So I use este because livro, it's masculino, okay? O livro, so I use este livro, I'm holding the book. If someone is next to me holding the book, I would say esse livro, because the person is still closer to me, but I am not holding the book. The person is holding the book, okay? So not este livro, esse livro. But imagine that I am referring to those books in the bookshelf. I would say aqueles livros, because it's far both for me and the person that I'm talking to. Again, if I'm holding the book, este livro. If the person next to me is holding the book, esse livro. If I'm referring to a book that is both far for me and the person I'm talking with, I would say aqueles livros. Why aqueles? Because they are plural, many books, okay? Aqueles livros. If it's another object, for example, caneta, okay? Caneta means pen. I would say esta caneta, because it's feminino, okay? Esta caneta. If it's a pen that, for example, Mariam is holding, I would say essa caneta, if she's next to me. Essa caneta. If I'm referring to a pen that is both far from me and for her, I would say aquela caneta. Okay, so did you got the point of this proximity or far away? I mean, it doesn't have to be very far away, but so I don't know. Some of you said that you only use o in Turkish if you cannot see the object. I don't know about that. I mean, in Portuguese, you can see the object. I mean, you have to see the object if you are referring to the object, because, I mean, that's the point. Seren or someone else, whoever wants to talk.
In Turkish, it's the same situation. You can say the auto object that you don't see, so it's okay. I mean, same thing, basically.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry.
Someone else? Obrigado. Someone else? Mais alguém?
And I wanted just to add as an additional information. Yes, you're exactly right. And it depends on the distance. But if we don't see the person, we can say O as well.
Okay. Obrigado. Someone else want to add anything? No? Okay. Yücel?
İhsan Bey, buyurun.
I couldn't lower my hand, I'm sorry.
Okay. No problem, sem problema. Now, these are the first set of demonstrativos, okay? They are called variáveis. Why variáveis? Variáveis means they vary, they change. They change according to what? They change according to proximidade, closer, afastamento, far. They change according to feminino masculino, feminino masculino, and they change according to singular and plural. So they are variable, okay? They are called variáveis. And we saw when do we use este or esta, esse, essa, aquilo, aquela, or the plural forms. But now I have some bad news. We have another set of demonstrativos called invariáveis. And when do we use the invariáveis? When do we use this? Okay? The invariáveis in Portuguese are isto, isso, and aquilo. Why they are called invariáveis? Because they don't change according to gender or number. They change according if they are closer or farther. So it's the same point as Shu and Onmar. The same, it's the same point. Okay, same thing. But when do we use this? I mean, what is the difference between variáveis and invariáveis? When do we use variáveis and when do we use invariáveis? We use invariáveis when we are referring to something that we don't know the name, or we don't use the name, the noun, isim, okay? Something that, and since we don't use the noun, we don't use the name, or we don't know what it is, we are asking, for example, bune, shune, one. For that question, we use invariáveis. What is the logic? Since we don't know what we are talking about, we are asking about it, we don't know the gender or the number. So if you don't know the gender or the number, we cannot use these variáveis. We have to use invariáveis. If this makes sense or not to you, well, I'm not going to get in there because it only complicates the use of the language. I know the case of Turkish, but also English, it's much easier because it doesn't have a gender, okay? And it doesn't vary. I mean, in Turkish you have bu, shu, o. In Turkish they have this and this, that and these. In Portuguese, fortunately or unfortunately, we can discuss this later, we have variáveis and invariáveis. When do we use invariáveis? Let me go to the other book. First of all, let me close this. Can you see both pages? Can you see the book and the Word document? Can you see both things now? Guys, can you see the Word page?
Sir, there is only a Word page.
Ah, so you cannot see the book.
No, we cannot see them at the same time.
I don't know why this is happening, because I'm sharing whatever I'm using. Anyway, I will try again. Can you see the book now?
Yes, the book is open, but there is no Word page now.
Yeah, yeah. What about now if I go to the Word page? Does it change?
It changes. We can only see one of them at the same time.
Yes, but if I change to the other thing, mm-hmm. Can you see it? Oh, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
Ah, okay, no problem. Okay, so let's go to the other book, Gramática Ativa, página 78. 78. Okay, so invariáveis. When do we use invariáveis? Let's see this case. The boy asks, o que é isto? And the man replies, isso é livro. That is a book. And then the kid is a bit far from the object and he asks, o que é isso? And the man replies, isto é caneta. This is a pen. Finally, both the kid and the man are far away from the object they are talking about, and the kid asks, o que é aquilo? Aquilo é carro. That is a car. So, on the question, since we are asking what is this, we are not referring to something that we know, or we are not referring to something specific, because we are asking what is this. So implicitly, it means we don't know. It doesn't have to be that we don't know what is the object. It can be like, what is this doing here? Or who owns this object, something like that. And then on the answer, we can already use the name of the object. But as you can see, we are using also article, which is artigo indefinido. We are not saying, this is one book, or this book is red, or this is José's book. We are saying this is a book. A book. So not a specific book. One book among others. This is a book. Okay? This is a pen. That is a car. So, we use invariáveis when we don't, we are not using directly the name of the object, or we are not giving specific information about the object. Let me give you an example. Imagine, I am walking with a friend, and I arrive next, we arrive next to a building, and I don't know what is this building. Okay, I know it's a building, but I don't know what specific building is. And I ask, o que é isto? Okay, I know it that is a building, but I'm trying to ask more information about that building. What that building is for, you know, what do they do inside? What type of building? So I ask a general question. What is this, Buné? O que é isto? And my friend answers, isto é estádio. This is a stadium. Estádio de futebol. Okay? Football stadium. Or, isto é teatro. Okay? And then it gives me more information about that football stadium, of that theater. And when he gives more information, he can already use the variáveis. For example, este é o estádio do... Let me use the football club I support. Este é o estádio do Benfica. Okay, Benfica is, for the ones who don't know, it's a football team in Lisbon. It's not important for the case. It can be also do Porto. But what matters here is when I'm already giving more information about the stadium, I use este, not isto. But to reply the first question, I use isto. So, what is this? This is a football stadium. It's, or this is the football stadium of Benfica. So on the first part, I'm using invariáveis. On the second part, I'm using variáveis. Let's do an exercise so we can see the problems you have. Before, I'm sure you have questions, but before we go to the last part of the class, the questions, let's do at least this exercise, okay? The first one. And then we can proceed to the questions. So let's look at the first sentence. In this exercise, we need to, maybe the second one. Okay, no, let's do this one. In this exercise, we have to select which is the correct option. Sublinha a opção correta. Sublinha means underline the correct option. Sublinha a opção correta. Estes são os meus gatos. Este são os meus gatos. Now, this is very easy because, as you can see, everything is plural. Okay, so it has also to be plural. So, these are my cats. Okay? These are my cats. B. Isabela. Dá-me. Dá-me means banavés. Okay? Give me. Dá-me esta caneta, por favor, ou essa caneta, por favor. If I'm asking Isabella to give me the pen, it means the pen is with her. So if it's with her, we use essa. Okay? Isabella, dá-me essa caneta, por favor. Now, we have... say it's more interesting because we have to decide between variáveis ou invariáveis. Vês aquilo ou aquela varanda ali? É da casa do meu tio. So what do you think? Aquilo ou aquela? Varanda means balcony. Ok? Balcony. Balcony. What do you think? Aquilo ou aquela? Vês means do you see? Do you see that varanda over there? Ali means over there. Do you see that varanda over there? What do you think? Aquilo ou aquela?
Serap Hanım, buyurun.
Vês aquela varanda ali.
Muito bem, Serap. Vês aquela varanda ali. What is the reason? Because we already have the name. We already have the thing that we are talking about. So if we have a name followed after the demonstrativo, it's variáveis, because we already have the object. And if we have the object, we know if we have to use feminino, masculino, if we have to use the closer ones or the far ones, if we have to use singular or plural. So, aquela varanda ali. É da casa do meu tio. It's from the house of my uncle. Let's do E now, because we also have to decide between variável ou invariável. Olha, aquele ou aquilo ali é terraço. This is a question. What do you think now? Aquilo ou aquele? Aquilo. Variável ou invariável?
Rianım, buyurun.
Olá.
Olá.
Oha, aquilo, ele é trecho. Trecho.
Olha, aquilo ali é terraço? Yes. Perfect. We have a name afterwards, but we are making a question. And we are using artigo indefinido. So we don't know if it is or not. Look, that over there is a terrace. Okay, terrace means terrace. That over there is a terrace. So we are not sure. And we are using ali. Ali means over there. So we have to use invariável. Okay. Last one, before we go to the questions, F. É a primeira vez que estou aqui. It's the first time that I am here. É a primeira vez que estou aqui. Primeira vez means first time, ok? Vez, it's like kere in Turkish. Aquilo é fabuloso, isto é fabuloso. Fabuloso means fabulous, fantastic. Which one do you think we have to use? Now that the difference, the question is between aquilo, both of them are invariável, but which one?
It shouldn't be isto.
Yes, it's isto. Why isto? Yeah. Because we say, it's the first time that I am here. This is great. What we are talking about? We don't know. We don't know if he's talking about a city, a cafe, house, we don't know, a garden, we don't know what, a museum, we don't know what he's talking about. We just know that he says, or she says, it's the first time that I am here. This is fabulous. This is great. This is fantastic. Okay? So again, we are using the infinito because we don't know. I mean, the person is not referring specifically to the place that he's talking about. So we use infinito. Okay?